Today I'm going to show you how to use the new Zoom virtual template backgrounds to help you stand out from your competition. Be sure to stay to the end of this video where I'm going to tell you how you can get on a discovery call with us so that we can help you move forward in your business. If you are truly ready to build your business, then be sure to click on the subscribe button below and ring the bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. Hi, my name is Jeanne Willson from Six Figure Business Coaching, and we have been coaching our clients and helping small businesses grow for the last 15 years. Our clients love using Canva and Zoom, and today I'm going to show you how to use the new creative virtual backgrounds in Canva for your online meetings, trainings, and workshops in Zoom.
So here we are in Zoom, and I'm going to show you some of the settings that you need to set up so that you are able to use the virtual background. So first thing you need to do is log in, which I've already done, and then go up here to My Account, and then over here to Settings, and then you're going to want to scroll down. You leave it on the meeting tab. I know it says meeting, recording, telephone. Leave it on the meeting tab and you scroll down until you see pass in meeting basic. We want to go to in meeting advanced. There it is. In meeting advanced. And underneath there, you're going to want to look for virtual background. Here it is. See that? And we want to make sure that's enabled. So here it already is because it's blue, but if it were gray like that, you just click on it once and it slides over and it's blue. So that means we have told Zoom that we do want to allow virtual backgrounds. So hopefully you can see me now and you can see that I have a green background. The best way to do this is actually with a green screen. And what we have here is not actually technically a green screen, but what it is a piece of fabric. We actually went to Joann Fabrics and bought a piece of fabric that is green. So it kind of mocks a green screen and put it where we normally put our backgrounds. So all we need to do here is go to our little settings where we normally go to video. There's a drop down. You can change your camera, but I'm going to say choose a virtual background. So one thing that I realized when I was recording is that when you are recording something on Zoom, when you're recording a meeting, it doesn't show the meeting controls at the top. So I had to use a different software to do that so I could show you what the host sees. And so in order to get the virtual background, you're using your meeting controls up here, and next to stop video is this drop down box. So you click on that, and one of the options is choose a virtual background. So we're going to click on that, and then I'm going to get my picture here out of the way. And now here's where we can choose a virtual background. So up here to get rid of the meeting controls, I'm going to click on more, and it says hide floating meeting controls. So now that's out of our way. If you want to get them back, you can see it tells you. You hit escape on your keyboard and they come back. So here you can see these are my settings for my video. And one of the settings is virtual background. So I can go there, and there are some that are already installed, and then there are a couple that I install myself. So one of the ones that's already installed is the Golden Gate Bridge. So you can see if I select that one, and then I go ahead and close this, and I make myself bigger. Here I am. How about that? I just think that's so cool. So, make that bigger. So there I am, the Golden Gate Bridge. So fun. So the next one I'm going to show you this green grass as a background. So you can try these out in this section right here to see what you think. Could be me in space on Earth. This is one that I uploaded from Canva. So it actually shows me in an office. And so if you are having a meeting and you have, you know, a background that's a little crazy or, you know, messy, you might be able to use this. It doesn't work quite as well without the green screen. The green screen is, you know, the optimal way to use it, but you can certainly give it a try. But it's a really exciting background. This one, I think, changes colors. But you can also see, can you see how my hair is kind of disappearing? So you also have to have some good lighting. So you may have to play around with the lighting that you have to make sure that you are very well lit. I actually had to grab a different camera that I have, which has changed. I can see some of the colors, like my lip color has changed, and I can see it's changed some of the colors. So you might notice these colors of my face and my hair and stuff are a little bit different than the rest of the video, because that was using a different type of video. So you're going to have to play around with it if you want to use these virtual backgrounds. But let me go ahead and close this, and I'm going to show you in Canva where you can find those backgrounds. So I'm already logged into Canva. So here, I've already got it because you can see I've searched for it. I'm just going to type in Zoom, and it says Zoom virtual background. So I'm hoping now that you can see Canva, and there's all these different fun backgrounds. You could pretend you're in London. You could be playing bingo. You could be an angel in the sky. You could be in a cubicle. So again, some of these can be, you know, just for fun if you're having events and meetings and get-togethers with friends. And some of them can be, you know, something that you use for work if you've got a background in your office, or, you know, if you're working from home and things are not ideal behind you, you may want to use one of these. So like I said, in Canva, you're just going to select one. You're going to make any edits that you want. This one says, can you hear me? But we don't have to keep that. We could change that to something else if we wanted to. And then we just download our designs to a folder. And there it is. And then we go over here and we choose a virtual background and we click the plus button. And we select that background, we open it up, and there it is. And then we close our selection, and there you go. Although I think it's backwards. So anyhow, I hope that you now understand better how to use virtual backgrounds and how much fun they can be, and actually how you can use them for your business. If you, like I said, if you've got some kind of crazy stuff going on in your background, you don't have a green screen, you don't have a screen at all, but you've got, you know, chaos, and you want to try and put a virtual background so it looks more like a professional office, not like the post-it notes, but maybe something more like the office. There you go. Something more like the office. So you can feel like you are meeting with other professionals in a professional environment. So I hope that you found this really informative. It's really fun. Be creative, you know, showcase your creativity if you are in a position to do that. If you're using Zoom for a webinar, you know, maybe do something a little bit fun. If you're using it for, you know, something casual for your business, some kind of training, but one that's, you know, that's a little bit fun and unique and creative, you know, think a little bit outside of the box. I think people would enjoy that. I think people would like to see something that was new and unique and out of the ordinary. So I hope that if you have any questions at all, please post them in the comments below. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have.
Now that you know how to use these creative backgrounds from Canva for your Zoom online meetings, be sure to click on the link below to book a discovery call with us so we can help you get to the next level in your business. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe, click the like button, ring the bell, and share it with your friends. And be sure to have a look at these other two videos where we've done some trainings to show you how to use Canva in other creative ways for your marketing. We are truly excited to be part of your entrepreneurial journey. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And until then, dream big.